In the previous video, we had already done the protective tissue, protective simple tissue, under which came the, or the examples were the epidermis and the cork. Today we will do the supportive tissue of plant tissues, which are parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. But today we will deal only with parenchyma. Now the characteristics of the parenchyma, as you see in this diagram, the parenchymatic cells are large and thin-walled. Their shape may be oval, spherical, polygonal, hexagonal, but whatever the shape may be, they are all isodiametric. What do you understand by isodiametric? They are all of the same diameter all around. So if it is a hexagonal, the diameter will be the same on all the sides. Okay, that is why they are known as isodiametric. Iso means same, diametric means diameter. So they are the same all around in the diameter. Now they have large intercellular spaces. You can see in this diagram, these are intercellular spaces. And these intercellular spaces provide buoyancy in aquatic plants. That means they can float, okay? They can float. These are living cells. Parenchymatic cells are living cells. They have a large vacuole. You can see in the diagram, the large vacuoles. And these vacuoles provide storage. Example is a potato. And the parenchymatic cells are made up of cellulose. Where can you find parenchymatic cells? In the soft parts of the plant, in the cortex of the stem and root. Cortex, as well as they are also present in the pith area. Cortex is the outermost. Cortex is the outermost layer and the pith is the inner layer of the vascular bundles. Okay. Now, they are also present in the mesophyll cells of the leaves, whereby they are named as palisade parenchyma, which is just below the epidermis, and the spongy parenchyma, which is present near the lower epidermis of the leaf, which are loosely packed. Okay. Now, the function of parenchyma is it stores food, provides temporary support to the plant, photosynthesis, helps in photosynthesis, and those parenchymatic cells which help in photosynthesis are known as chlorenchyma. Okay, they also help in buoyancy in aquatic plants, and these are then called or known as, those parenchymatic cells are known as erenchyma. Fine. So this is all about parenchyma. Now along with this, I'm giving you a biology worksheet for class 7. Dated today, dated on the day the video will be uploaded. Now this is the worksheet. Define cell. Number 2, how is a tissue formed? Define tissue. Number 3, draw a flow chart to show different types of plant and animal tissues. Number 4, name the actively dividing cells found in plants. Number 5, draw a label diagram of meristematic tissue and parenchyma tissue. Number 6, why are parenchyma cells said to be isodiametric in nature? Now, whatever paper or stationery you are having, you will do it in that itself, but the work should be neat and clear. Thank you. Next video, we will be doing collenchyma.